Note, the following video depicts a specific configuration of the notebook. The same removal and replacement procedures apply to all configurations of the notebook. Before you begin, remove the optical drive, base enclosure, battery, wireless module, and fan. Removal. Important: make careful note of the routing of all cables connected to the system board for later replacement. Disconnect the power connector cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the display panel cable ZIF connector and disconnect the display panel cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Disconnect the speaker cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the power button board ZIF connector and disconnect the power button board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the power button board ribbon cable from the adhesive that secures it to the USB board ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the USB board ZIF connector and disconnect the USB board ribbon cable from the USB board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the touchpad board ZIF connector and disconnect the touchpad board ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the keyboard light ZIF connector and disconnect the keyboard light ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the hard disk drive adapter ZIF connector and disconnect the hard disk drive adapter ribbon cable from the system board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the card reader board ZIF connector and disconnect the card reader board ribbon cable from the card reader board. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Remove the two 5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Lift the system board off of the alignment pins on the top cover and remove. Replacement. Note: before installing a new system board, remove the following from the old system board and install on the new system board: heatsink, memory boards, RTC battery, USB board ribbon cable, card reader board ribbon cable. Place the system board onto the alignment pins on the top cover. Caution: ensure that all the cables are free from being pinched between the system board and top cover. Replace the two 5mm P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Insert the card reader board ribbon cable into the card reader board ZIF connector on the card reader board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the hard disk drive adapter ribbon cable into the hard disk drive adapter ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the keyboard light ribbon cable into the keyboard light ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution: use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the keyboard ribbon cable into the keyboard ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the touchpad board ribbon cable into the touchpad board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the USB board ribbon cable into the USB board ZIF connector on the USB board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Insert the power button board ribbon cable into the power button board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Apply pressure to the length of the power button board ribbon cable to adhere it to the USB board ribbon cable. Connect the speaker cable into its connector on the system board. Insert the display panel cable into the display panel cable ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Caution! Use care to prevent damaging the ZIF connector and ribbon cable. Connect the power connector cable into its connector on the system board. Important! After system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.